Woke up this morning with my mind.
Woke up this morning, stayed on freedom.
Woke up this morning with my mind.
Woke up this morning, stayed on freedom.
Woke up this morning with my mind.
January 9th, 1866, 6 months after the last shot was fired in the Civil War, the Fisk University opened for classes in Nashville, Tennessee, a permanent university for the higher education of the freed people.
The Fisk University was founded on faith
and precious little else.
Its founders shared a burning ideal to provide education and improvement to the vast colored population of the South, set free by the violent emancipation of the war.
4 million souls suddenly cast adrift, homeless, penniless, ignorant, improvident,
unprepared in every way for the dangers as well as the duties of freedom.
Now that the fetters had fallen from mind as well as body, there sprang an eagerness to learn that was like a consuming fire.
Families pinched with hunger asked more eagerly for schools than for bread.
Women of 70 mastered the alphabet in a week.
Old men bent over the same spelling books with their grandchildren.
Fathers would work all day and then walk every night to an evening school miles away.
Their gratitude for instruction was as fervent as their desire for it was ravenous.
Woke up this morning with my mind.
Woke up this morning, stayed on freedom.
Woke up this morning with my mind.
Woke up this morning, stayed on freedom.
Woke up this morning with my mind.
Woke up and stayed on freedom.
Founders chose as the dark heart of the slaving South, and it was little wonder, therefore, that it was next to impossible to purchase land for the new campus.
No landowner would sell.
But Providence intervened in the persons of Professor John Ogden and General Clinton B. Fisk, who joined in the purchase of a former hospital barracks of the Union Army.
At the price of $16,000.
Ouch!
Out of their own pockets.
The officers' quarters became the home of an earnest band of teachers.
The sick wards were fitted up as schoolrooms and filled with hundreds of eager children.
The dead house was turned into a storeroom of supplies for the naked and the hungry.
And a great pile of rusty handcuffs and fetters from the city's abandoned slave pen was sold for old iron, and the money invested in the purchase of testaments and spelling books.
This morning.